Here we have for sale our one owner from new 2020 on a 70 plate Ford Transit Custom. This is the 320 model, meaning it's got a 3.2 ton gross vehicle weight. This one has got the 2 liter EcoBlue Euro 6 diesel engine producing 185 PS in this particular example, and roughly 185 brake horsepower, which is the highest brake horsepower that they do in these vans. This is the L1 or short wheelbase double cab limited van, and what we're going to do in this video is have a little walk around. I'll show you the spec that you get on a Ford Transit Custom Limited double cab of this age. We'll also talk you through the factory optional extras which are on this particular van. We'll also talk you through the bits which have been added afterwards, and also the service history, seeing as it is currently available for sale at the time of recording. The other thing I didn't mention there when I was running through the model is that this one is the automatic, so it's got that lovely 6-speed automatic gearbox as well to go along with that powerful engine. Starting here then at the rear of the vehicle, and the first thing to note here, which is not quite standard, is this one has got a rear unglazed tailgate. So a tailgate is one door which comes up like so. The other option which you can get, which is probably the more often seen version, is barn doors, which are two doors which open like so. So this is a really nice desirable extra, especially in a double cab van. I can also see here that this one has got a reversing camera, which would also not come as standard on a Custom Limited, so that's a really nice factory optional extra as well. Things that you do get as standard, things color-coded, so bits like this trim here above the rear number plate, the bumpers, the mirrors, trims down the side of the vehicle, they all come color-coded in the body color, which in this case is metallic magnetic gray, a lovely popular color for these vans. You also get parking sensors as standard as well, so you get rear parking sensors and front parking sensors. I can see that the previous owner was clearly security minded, so they've had some deadlocks fitted to the rear door. And what I quite like with these is they're quite subtle. I've seen deadlocks before where there's a big slam lock here right in the middle of the door and can be quite off-putting, but these are just subtle and down here out of the way. You don't need to use those, but of course it does add extra security. And even if they're not used, they certainly act as a deterrent as well. Looking here then at the rear of the vehicle, we can see that this one has had a lovely rear spoiler fitted to the back of it, which just ties in with the rest of the sporty trim which has been added. In terms of condition here at the rear, just before I open up the rear tailgate, I mean, the condition is absolutely spot on. The rear bumper is looking very nice. The condition of the paintwork here to the tailgate, absolutely spot on. There's really not much I can fault that on. Opening up the back then, the theme very much continues in the back of here. So absolutely stunning condition throughout the van really, but especially here in the rear, certainly well cared for. So you can see that it's been carpet lined on the roof panels and on the side panels as well. Of course, you've got the factory fitted bulkhead there, which can be removed. They are just bolted in around the outside, but that does really give you a fantastic separation there between the load space of the van and the cab space of the vehicle as well. So I always like to see those in vans where you can, because it really does also help to deaden down any sound which can come in from the back of the vehicle as well. Nice wheel arch protectors, which come as standard on the limited model, with some nice tie down points as well, dotted around the base of the vehicle. Again, previous owner has clearly looked after this van. They've had a really nice rubber mat put in here. And what that does, it just protects the floor so well underneath. There's a you know, the original rubber mat is underneath that, the rubber flooring, should I say, but a really nice tailored mat has been put in there to really set it off as well. Another factory optional extra then is that this one has got the LED load lights, which in lower light conditions makes a massive difference inside there. But as I say, condition is absolutely spot on, and also looking at the inside of the tailgate as well, all carpeted in there. Let's continue around the outside of the vehicle. So this is where we can start having a look down the sides of the van. You can see here, very, very straight and clean. Really is quite remarkable. This van didn't require a huge amount of preparation when it came into us, as I said, just the nature of how clean it was when it arrived. But of course, during our preparation, we still thoroughly go through the vehicle. So we've given it a multi-point health check in the workshop. It's had a brand new MOT, and it had brand new rear brake pads as well as part of our checks. We do have evidence of two previous services having been carried out. Previous was in November of 22 at about 20 or 22,000 miles. So as I say, only very little miles has been covered, as we'll come on to a little bit later on. So as I say, didn't require another service. They're due 25,000 every 2 years on these vans. But as I say, previous owner has had two previous services done, which is, again, so nice to see. The wheels which have been added to this particular vehicle are the ever popular Caliber T-Sport 20-inch gloss black alloy wheels, of course fully load rated with load rated tyres. They're all absolutely brand new. A nice set of side bars and roof bars as well, which just tie together really, really nicely. On the factory double cabs then, you do get twin glazed side loading doors as standard with opening windows. But having a look here at the condition in the back, again, you can almost guess what it's going to look like, and that is absolutely spot on in here. Same with the floor, nice carpet over mat. Of course, they do come with carpet on the floor as standard, but just, again, looking at the seats, there's no rips, tears, cigarette burns. It doesn't smell like a smoker's vehicle or pet vehicle or anything like that. It's lovely in the back of here. Isofix compatibility, of course, on the two outer seats, and again, condition of the headlining as well. Not a tremendous amount to fault in there. If we open up the passenger door then, and have a look inside here. Passenger door card is looking very nice. The passenger step, if I move this out of the way as well, the previous owner had the proper transit rubber overmats fitted. We've actually even got the bill for that within the paperwork. As I say, just nice little touches like that to show that they've really cared for it. There are some little superficial sort of surface scratches here to the glove box. We see this a lot on customs. As I say, just light marks, of course, doesn't affect it in any way, but certainly worth mentioning. Looking at the passenger seats, again, absolutely very much the same as the back. You've got nice storage underneath these seats as well. And again, just shows how clean it is, and but also a testament to how well our chaps here repair and prepare the vehicles with just, again, how clean it is in here, and they do not miss anything. There's no stone left unturned, should we say. Moving around to the front, I can see that the previous owner has had some nice black wing mirror caps fitted, which actually ties in quite nicely with the wheels and the sidebars, I think. Looking around here to the front, there's a nice front splitter on there, and we've also got the, again, very popular Ford Trail front grille. That just sets the van off so, so well at the front. Being the Limited, it does come with, of course, these headlights here, and also the lovely LED daytime running light around the outside. I think I've actually got them turned off at the moment, so that's not particularly handy, but a lovely LED daytime running light there around the outside. Front fog lights, they also act as cornering lights as well as you're going around a corner, and front parking sensors as well. In terms of condition here at the front, there's a couple of stone chips, of course, as you would expect, to the bonnet. A couple of, again, tiny little stone chips here or there to the front end, as you would expect with any used vehicle, but absolutely not excessive. It's looking really, really smart. And looking then down the driver's side of the vehicle, and again, just having a look there for any dents or ripples or signs of previous repair, it is looking spot on. Very, very smart. There's not even really particularly touch-ins I can show you here. It's really that clean. Again, upgraded driver's door lock, which just adds that extra touch of security, as I mentioned. Opening up the driver's side loading door, again, gives you access into those rear seats. And that is lovely to have that on a double cab van. Of course, all custom Limited double cabs come with that as standard, to be able to load into those rear seats from both sides. Just makes a really nice practical difference when you're using these every day. Opening the driver's door then, we can start to have a look inside here. So having a look at the driver's door card. Up on top of here then, we have electric windows, electric folding mirrors, and that's how those operate there, just by pulling on that dial there back towards you. You've got auto activated lights and auto activated wipers. You can just leave that in the A for auto and it will sort itself out for you. Two full remote flip keys with the vehicle, and of course a number of spares for the deadlocks as well. leather multifunctioning steering wheel. On the left-hand side, you've got your onboard computer. You haven't got your onboard computer on the left. You've got your cruise control on the left-hand side, excuse me. Underneath that, your volume for the radio underneath. And on the right-hand side, that is where you've got your onboard computer controls. And underneath that, you can answer and hang up the phone. Looking at the mileage then, 25,466 miles. So really nice mileage on this van. Certainly not excessive at all. Plenty of easy access storage up on top of the dashboard, and you've got a USB and a 12 volt socket up on top of there as well. Another factory optional extra on this particular vehicle is below the handbrake. This one has got the 230 volt power converter. My camera with a gimbal cannot fit down there, unfortunately, but there we go. That is the 230 volt 3-pin socket there underneath the handbrake, and that is a really handy feature to have. So you've got a proper 3-pin socket underneath there. Automatic gearbox, as I mentioned a little bit earlier on in the video, which is of course very popular, very desirable on the double cab vans. We have got air conditioning, heated windscreen, heated front seats, and heated door mirrors there as well. I pointed to the heated door mirror for the heated windscreen button, but those are, so that's your heated windscreen, that's your heated mirrors. Up above that then, you've got your Sync 3 screen, so this gives you Apple CarPlay and Android Auto as well, all seamlessly here on the screen, so you can really use those apps exactly really as you would do on your phone. So you can navigate on here via Apple Maps, Google Maps or Waze if you want to. You can listen to your favorite podcasts on here if you want. You can listen to your music, as I say, all seamlessly as you would do on your phone. Say multiple pages there for multiple different apps. Very, very smart indeed. If you put the vehicle then into reverse, this is where your rear camera will be displayed, just there, like so. So just to summarize this particular vehicle then, as I mentioned right at the start of the video, this is a one owner from new 2020, it's a November 2020 on a 70 plate Ford Transit Custom Limited double cab short wheelbase with a 185 Euro 6 engine. Of course, Euro 6, you can take this into the ultra low emissions zone areas or clean air zones if you would like to as well. It is fully compliant with those areas. We hold a fantastic service history. Two previous Ford services have been carried out. Most recently, it was either 20 or 22,000 miles, but certainly low 20,000 miles, and we're now only on 25, and that was in November of 22. Lots of 20s going on there, but trying to remember which one is correct. So really nice service history with the vehicle. We've put it right through our workshop as well for a health check and an MOT, including the rear brake pads. Absolutely stunning van. Lovely optional extras as well. So you've got the LED load lights, the reversing camera, the 230 volt power converter there in the front. Also, of course, the full body styling and stunning condition throughout, it must be said. If you'd like to see the full advert, if you haven't seen already, please head over to our website, bridgeendvans.co.uk. This is where you'll find the price, the description, and the photography of this vehicle, and of course all of the others that we've currently got advertised. You can contact us in a number of ways, but by all means pick up the phone. If you are serious about inquiring about this vehicle, I don't need to say it, you'll probably see on our website, but they do sell quite quickly. So it is worth picking up the phone if you are interested, but of course you can make inquiries via a number of ways via our website as well. We can take cars or vans in part exchange. We can arrange finance at very competitive rates, but we can also deliver our vans nationwide as well. Thank you very much for watching.